Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see a frequently asked interview question, which is the spiral matrix traversal. So let us look at the problem statement. Let us assume that you are given a n by m matrix, which may be a square matrix or maybe a rectangular matrix. In this case I have taken a square matrix. Let's say you have a matrix and then you are required to print this matrix elements in a spiral format. So when you move in a spiral format, first you will print the first row, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, this one. Then you will move down and print 8, 12, 16. Then move left and print 15, 14, 13. Move up and print 9, 5. Move to the right and print 6, 7. Move down and print only 11. And move to the left and print 10. And this is the ending point. This is what we want to do. So let us look at how can we solve this. In order to solve this, I will use a very tricky method which will make this problem very simple. So let us see how can we solve it. In order to solve, we will take four pointers. One is pointing to the first row, the top pointer. One is pointing to the last row, the down pointer. Now we will require two pointers for the columns as well. This is the left and the right. So these four are actually marking the boundary of our spiral movement. This will restrict our movement. So let us see how can we solve it. First of all, I will assign top equals to 0 and I will assign down equals to n minus 1. I will assign next left equals to 0 since it is pointing to the 0th column, and then right equals to n minus 1. Now what we will do is we will take a direction pointer. So int direction equals to 0 initially. 0 means we will move from left to right. 1 will mean we will move from top to down. 2 will mean we will move from right to left, and 3 will mean we will move from bottom to top. So these are the four values which we will be moving to see in which direction we want to move. So let us solve this question now. Don't look at the while condition. Okay, don't look at the while condition, and I will not fill it up right now. Let us just write the conditions and then finally we will come to know what we will give for the while condition. So if our direction is equals to 0, that means if we want to move from left to right, initially this condition will be true, and therefore I have already mentioned here direction equals to 0. By the way, this is direction. So I have mentioned direction equals to 0. So if this is true, what will we do? We will just print the first row. So we will move I from where to where we want to print. We want to print from left to right. Actually, this one is the left and this one is the right. You can see that left is pointing to 0th column, right is pointing to the last column. So we want to print from left to right. And then what row we want to print? We want to print a static row, which is top. That means we don't want to change the row. Row will be same. So we will write here print, and it will be, if the array name is, let's say it's A only, then we will print A at row name will be top and column will be changing. So column will be I. Okay, and after we are done with printing this, 1, 2, 3, 4 will be printed, and after printing this, what will we do? We will have to shift this top one position down, since we have already printed this first row. So we will write here top plus equals to 1, because we want to increase the value of top, and now top will be pointing to row number 1. This was index 0, this is index 1. So now it will be pointing to 1. So this is the first case. What will be the second case? We will write it in else if. Else if direction equals to 1. That means if we want to move from top to down, then what will we do? We have already printed 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are at this location. We want to print 8, 12 and 16. So what we will do? We will have to again take a loop. Now this will move from top, is actually pointing to this location now. So we will print from top to down, since this 8 is being pointed by top. This row is pointed by top, and the last row is pointed by down. So we want to print from top to down. And what we want is we want to keep our column fixed. It will be static, it will be fixed. So we want to keep this right as fixed. So what will we print? We want to print the array at, in this case your row will be changing. First you will be printing this 8, then you will be printing this 12. So you can see that your row number is changing but your column is same. So in this case your row will be I and your column will be fixed, which will be right. Now once you have printed this column, then what you need to do is you need to move this right pointer one to the left, because you have already finished printing this column pointed by right. So right will now move one position to the left. So what will we do is right minus equals to 1. So right will move one position to the left. Now let us look at the next case. What will be the next case? The next case will be else if direction equals to 2. We have already printed this 1, 2, 3, 4. We have printed this 8, 12, 16. Now right is pointing to this point. Top is pointing to this point. This is top. Now what do we want to print? We want to print this 15, 14, 13. This is the last row. So we will use a loop. We will start from where will we start? You can see that this is pointed by right. Actually right has moved one position to the left. So we will start from this right and we will go till left. So it will be till left. So we are decreasing the value and then we will print. In this case you can see that we have the row as fixed and columns are changing. So we will write row as down, because row is being pointed by down and column is not fixed, so it will be I. And once you have printed all these values, you are at this 13. Actually you have printed this last row. So when you have printed this last row, you will decrement this value of down. So down will now be pointing one position up. So you will have to decrement the value of this down by 1. I hope you are getting it. Now what do you want to do? Actually you want to print these two values, 9 and 5. So this is our fourth case, when direction is 3. So in this case you will start from down. You will have to start from down and you will move till the top, from down to top, and you will print. In this case you can see that your column is fixed and your rows are changing, your rows are decreasing. So for the row part you will give I, since this I is looping, and for the column part, since it is fixed, you will write it as left, since the column is being pointed by left. Once you have printed this entire column, then what will be done? Actually you need to increase this left pointer, and left will now be pointing to one position to the right. So you will write left plus equals to 1. This will move left to the right. Now after doing this, you will have to write direction equals to direction plus 1 mod 4, so that once you start from direction equals to 0, this first case will be run. This first case will be run and the first row will be printed. Once you have printed this, then all these else if conditions will be skipped, and so you want to print in the next direction. So you want to print from top to down. So this direction will initially be 0, 1 will be added and you will take mod of 4, which will be equals to 1. So now this one is showing that you want to print from top to down. Once you have printed this top to down using this second case, then all the else if conditions will be skipped, and then direction value will be 1, 1 will be added, it will be done with mod 4, and then the value will come as 2. Now this 2 is showing that you will have to print from right to left, and similarly you will have to print from down to top. So this will get repeated, and once you hit a value 4, then again on taking mod 4 your value will be 0. So you will be moving from this left to right again. So this top, down, left and right is actually used for the boundary cases, because this is showing what you have printed and what you need to print. So this is keeping track of the values you need to print, top, down, left and right. While this direction is used to state in which direction you need to print next. So this is the entire solution in order to print this matrix in a spiral way. The code for this problem will be present in the description section below, so do check it out. I hope you are able to understand this problem. If you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you on our next video. Thank you.